Right now, the nation's pennies and other coins are in short supply. Some retailers have even posted signs asking for exact change only. Look at that. We found these at a Home Depot in Marlboro and a Big Y in Norwood. The Federal Reserve blames the coin disruption on the pandemic, and the Mass Bankers Association says it's just temporary.
It's a classic supply and demand issue. With stores closed, laundromats closed, universities, in schools, big users of coins, there was no way to get the money back into circulation. But as the economy opens and more small businesses open, the problem should resolve itself.
Now, another challenge for the coin supply, Mass Bankers says about 95% of all financial transactions now can be done electronically, which means fewer people are using cash anymore anyway. The pandemic has likely increased the use of touch-free services, especially digital payments. Public health experts say they are safer than using cash. I don't know about you, Emily, but I hardly ever use cash.
Banks may be short on coins in the Ozarks thanks to the coronavirus. Michael Deer has the latest on the nationwide ripple effect hitting home.
I cannot imagine us living in a cashless society. I just don't think it would work.
Heather Christopher has seen social media posts about the coin shortage. Saturday, she went to give a customer change and noticed she was down to her last penny.
I had not thought about it happening in West Plains, but I had to give a nickel back because I'm down to one penny. I couldn't give change for 4 cents. I had to give them a nickel.
Tim Cates, owner of the Washboard, relies on people's change to make a living. He doesn't want to see a card-driven society.
I'm not looking forward to it. I like the old way.
Cates has enough coins that he is actually in a position to help.
As far as my business, I've actually sold some to a local bank.
The Federal Reserve said last month it would limit the amount of coins it sends to banks due to the shortage caused by the pandemic. Kevin Dietz's arcade games inside the Washboard business made him a prime candidate for banks on the hunt for coins.
I've had a couple banks call me and ask me if I'm coming in with some loads of quarters for them.
That no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name.